Hello everyone, myself Aneesa. This video is on Food Safety and Standards Act 2006. This is an important topic for food safety officer exams. So, coming to the topic, the objectives of this act is to consolidate the laws relating to food and to establish the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India for laying down science-based standards for articles of food and to regulate their manufacture, storage, distribution, sale and import to ensure availability of safe and wholesome food for human consumption and for matters connecting therewith. This act came into effect from 24th August 2006. Next is definitions of some of the important terms in this act. First one is adulterant. Material which can cause food unsafe or substandard or misbranded. Next is Commissioner of Food Safety. The Commissioner of Food Safety appointed under Section 30. Contaminant is any substance which is present in food as a result of production, manufacture, processing, preparation, treatment, packing, packaging and transport. Designated officer, the officer appointed under Section 36. Food additive, any substance used as a typical ingredient of food. Food analyst, an analyst appointed under Section 45. Food authority. Food Safety and Standards Authority of India is established under the Section 4. Food business means any undertaking for profit or not and whether public or private is food business. Food business operator, a person by whom the business is carried out on or owned and is responsible for ensuring the compliance of this act, rules and regulation made thereunder. Next term is food laboratory. Any food laboratory or institute established by the central or a state government or any other agency and accredited by National Accreditation Board for testing and calibration laboratories or an equivalent accreditation agency and recognized by Food Authority under Section 43. Food safety is assurance that food is acceptable for human consumption according to its intended use. Food safety officer is appointed under Section 37. Hazard, a biological, chemical or physical agent in or condition of food with the potential to cause an adverse health effect. License is granted under Section 31 of this Act. Substandard, items that does not meet the specified standards. Tribunal, Food Safety Appellate Tribunal established under Section 70. Unsafe food, injurious to health. Next is authorities and officers of food safety. The establishment of Food Safety and Standards Authority of India is explained under Section 4. The central government established Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. Its headquarters is at Delhi. The food authority can establish its offices at any places in India. The authority consists of a chairperson and 22 members, out of which one-third should be women, which is explained in the Section 5. The term of member of the authority is 3 years and they are eligible for reappointment for further 3 years, as explained in Section 7. In Section 9 of this Act, it is explained that Food Authority has a Chief Executive Officer whose rank should not be below the rank of Additional Secretary to the Government of India, and he shall be the Member Secretary of the Authority and appointed by the Central Government. By the approval of Central Government, Food Authority determine the number, nature and categories of other officers and employees required to the Food Authority and the salaries and allowances payable to Chief Executive Officer, officers and other employees by following the regulations specified by the Food Authority. The Chief Executive Officer is the legal representative of food authority by section 10. His duties includes every year the chief executive officer should submit to the authority to approve a general report covering all the activities of food authority in the previous year, programs of work, the annual accounts for the previous year and the budget for the coming year. And he should forward the general report and the programs to the central government, and the government will publish it. He should approve all the financial expenditure of food authority and report on authority's activities to the central government. Chief executive officer can exercise the powers of the commissioner of food safety while dealing with the matters relating to food safety of such articles. He have the administrative control over the officers and other employees of the food authority. Next is functions of food authority. It is explained in the section 16. The important functions include to regulate and monitor the manufacture, processing, distribution, sale and import of food so as to ensure safe and wholesome food. Provide scientific advice and technical support to the central government and the state government in matters of framing the policy and rules in areas which have direct or indirect bearing on food safety and nutrition. Chapter 4 of this Food Safety and Standards Act deals with the general provisions as to articles of food. The important provisions include Section 19 explains the use of food additives or processing aids should be in accordance with the provisions of this Act. Section 20 explains no article of food shall contain any contaminant, naturally occurring toxic substances or toxic or hormone or heavy metal in excess of such quantities as may be specified by the regulation. Next is Section 21. In this section, no article of food shall contain insecticides or pesticides residues, veterinary drugs residues, antibiotic residues, solvent residues, pharmacological active substances, and microbiological counts in excess of tolerance limit specified. No insecticide shall be used directly on article of food except fumigants registered and approved under the Insecticides Act 1968. Section 22. No person shall manufacture, distribute, sell or import any novel food, generally genetically modified articles of food, irradiated food, organic food, food for special dietary uses, functional foods, nutraceuticals, health supplements, preparatory foods, and other articles of food within the central government may notify in its behalf. Section 23 is about packaging and labeling of food should be in specific manner, and the labeling and presentation should not mislead the consumer. Section 24 is about no advertisement shall be made of any food which is misleading or deceiving or contravenes the provisions of this Act. No person shall engage himself in any unfair trade practice for purpose of promoting the sale, supply, use and consumption of articles of food. Next is Prohibition Orders. Section 33 explains on Prohibition Orders. If a food business operator is convicted on an offence and the health risk exists with respect to that food business, then the court will hear the food business operator and after that imposes the following prohibitions: on the use of process or treatment for the purpose of food business, on the use of premises or equipments for the purpose of food business or any other food business of the same class or description, on the use of premises or equipments for the purpose of any food business. So the court can impose prohibition on the food business operator participating in the management of any food business or any food business of a class or class or description specified in the order. The food business operator can apply to cease the prohibition of orders by not less than 6 months after prohibition order has been passed. Court will not entertain any application of food business operator if it is not made within 6 months after making the prohibition order or within 3 months after making by the food business operator of a previous application for such a direction. Next is procedure for investigation and launching prosecutions. The food safety officer can search any place, seize any article of food or adulterant if there is a reasonable doubt. By applying the provisions of Code of Criminals Procedure 1973 relating to search, seizure, summon, investigation and prosecution, he can take appropriate actions. Section 42 explains on the procedure for launching a prosecution. So the food safety officer is responsible for inspection of food business, drawing samples and sending them to a food analyst. Now food analyst analyzes the received sample and send the analysis report mentioning the method of sampling and analysis within 14 days to a designated officer with a copy to Commissioner of Food Safety. Now the designated officer scrutiny the report of food analyst and he decides whether the contravention punishable with an imprisonment or he shall say with a fine only, and in the case of contravention punishable with imprisonment he shall send his recommendation within 14 days to the Commissioner of Food Safety for sanctioning prosecution. And now the commissioner decides according to the gravity of the offense, he decides whether the matter referred to a court of ordinary jurisdiction in case of offenses punishable within imprisonment for a term up to 3 years, or a special court in case of offenses punishable with imprisonment for a term exceeding 3 years, where such special court is established. Now, and the Commissioner of Food Safety should communicate his decisions to the designated officer and concerned food safety officer, who should launch the prosecution before the court of ordinary jurisdiction or special court. So that's all in this video. I will be continuing this topic in my next video. Hope this video is useful.